covering the week's top tech stories with a slight Linux bias.
To help with the self-isolation blahs, Google has made its Stadia Pro video game streaming service free for 2 months. Phil Harrison, the head of Google Stadia, wrote on Google's blog, "Video games can be a valuable way to socialize with friends and family when you're stuck at home. So we're giving gamers in 14 countries free access to Stadia for 2 months. Unlike before, where you had to order the Stadia controller and the Chromecast Ultra in order to subscribe, now all you need is a Gmail account, which many of us already have, for free. With while most games available to stream through Google Stadia need to be bought, the Pro subscription does come with some free ones. The most notable of these are Destiny 2, Grid, SteamWorld Quest, Hand of Gilgamesh, and Thumper. Stadia Pro is normally a $10 monthly subscription. Those already subscribed simply won't get billed for the next 2 months. While people signing up for the first time will get all the benefits of Pro, and will be switched to a free account after 2 months. Pro benefits include access to the free game library and the ability to stream them at a higher quality than just 1080p and 60 frames per second. During this period, however, Google will be adjusting their bandwidth usage to cope with the influx of new users and the increase of people streaming stuff online in general. Like, we're all at home these days, right? So as a result, the default will be 1080p instead of the 4K. However, you can switch that in settings for now. If you're new to Stadia, go to stadia.com to sign up, download the Stadia app on Android or iOS, and then you can play on your laptop, desktop, Chrome OS tablet with your favorite controller or mouse and keyboard. Again, just some personal thoughts on this story. It's a very interesting time to be a gamer for sure. Again, Stadia Pro has had its positives as well as negatives, such as the idea that people aren't too happy with having to buy their games again to play in a cloud platform. With that being said, there's other alternatives available if you don't want to get into Stadia and Google, such as the Xbox Game Pass, how, again, you have a huge library of games that you buy that are very often cross-platform, so you can play these games on your Xbox as well as on your PC, etc., with a single account, your Xbox account, or you can even do the other service that I personally prefer, the NVIDIA GeForce Now, where basically you're using NVIDIA servers to play your games. However, it's actually a free service. You can play up to an hour for free, or you can play up to, I believe, 6 or 8 hours, paying around $10 a month Canadian. But basically what this service entails is that you don't have to buy your games a second time. You basically just log in to Steam, My Games, or even free games such as War Thunder, World of Warships, World of Tanks, whatever, and you can actually play your games that you already own on this free service. Well, if you play only for an hour. But again, I've used it, I'm very happy with it, and again, you don't have to buy your games twice, which is the big factor with Stadia. Will Stadia prove worthy? Let's decide. You can now play for 2 months. What a great time to be able to get into streaming your games.